Hi, I'm Mark from L&M Small Engine. Today we're working on a Troy Bilt 3000 PSI power washer with a Briggs & Stratton Intec engine on it. Pulled her open and just don't want to start. But what I found out on these Intec engines is for some reason these plastic gas tanks that sit on top of the engine for some reason, if it's condensation or what, but they're always seems to have water in the carburetor. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna tear the carburetor off and take the tank off and make sure the gas is nice and clean there so we can't get this running. So anyway, I hope you enjoy the video. So let's go ahead and take this air filter cover off. That's a 5/16 nut driver. I'll go ahead and take this back plate off the air filter base to get to the carburetor. Okay. Then the carburetor to 3/8. 3/8 inch of that bolt tool and take the carburetor off. I'm going to take the gas line off. And we got to be very careful because this inlet part in the carburetor is plastic and they can break really easy. So we have to be careful there. We're going to go ahead and take this gas tank off too and just drain it, blow it out. Like I said, for some reason, these particular horizontal motors with this plastic tank, for some reason, they always have water in them. I don't know if because the motor gets hot faster in the tank, it produces condensation or what. Seems like every time though there's water in these tanks. And water is heavier than gas, so it just goes down and sits in the bottom of the carburetor where the jet is and it won't start. Well, we'll take it apart and find out for sure. I'm going to turn this gas to the off position. There's like a notch right there. And there's a notch right here in the center of that. So this stuff will just slide off this covering. So that way we can get to our bolts. There's two bolts up here and two in back. So I believe these are 10 millimeters. Tank totally loose down with those unhook it over here. Now we can take the carburetor off and unhook the governor linkage. Spring. There we go. I'm going to clean this off before I tear it apart so we don't get that dirt on the inside of the carburetor and don't lose this here. I'm going to go ahead and change the spark plug. I'm going to use my suction tank, suck out all the oil, put brand new oil in there, a new plug, and we're going to boil this out, blow out the tank, and put it back together, see if we can get this thing running so they can wash some cars. Okay, we just got it boiled out, the ultrasonic boiler. See how nice and clean everything is? And we're going to put it all back together again, and this is your jet. That goes in here. You gotta make sure holes in the side, you blow in there and that hole right there is clear. That's how the gas gets into the motor, see right there. So make sure that's nice and clean. So now we're going to put our seat in for our needle. See how it's nice and smooth and beveled on this side here, and this side as it's rigid. This goes in the carburetor first. It goes right in there. Okay, it's sitting in there now. When I got this drill bit, I use the back side. It just fits in there nice and tight because it's tapered down in here. It's tapered where that seat is pressed in there. So I stick it in there like that, and you push it up against something. Nice and tight in there. Okay, we'll put our bowl gasket on. we'll put our float in there. Put our pin in. Now we put our bowl on there. And our new gasket. Just like that. Okay, now we're gonna change the spark plug, put new oil in there, and put this back on there, and I blew up the gas tank. Get that put on there, put some gas in there, it should fire right up. Grab our new plug. That's nice and snug. Okay, I put some new oil in there now. It's usually 16 ounces that these take. Make sure that's tight. Okay, let's put the carburetor on now. Okay, we're gonna put the spring on there. The spring, that's what keeps that governor rod tight so it don't fluctuate. Put our rod in now, just like that. Okay, now we gotta put the gas tank on. Put our cover on. Now we can put our base cover on. Yeah, some new air filter in, but I'm not. Put some gas in this real quick and we'll see if we can fire it off. Okay, I put a little bit of water in the pump. I'm just going to start it and shut it right back off because I don't want it in the pump. I just want to make sure it's going to start. But normally you have water go in the pump. So, see what it does here. Got the valve on full, gas on, chokers on. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching, and you have a good day. Thanks, bye.
Hi, this is Mark from L&M Small Engine. If you like my videos, please like and subscribe. Thanks.